Hello everyone, I am Rajesh from ACM Technology. Today is review class. I am going to review already what you learn, what you finish already, right? And we finished too many things, but today I am going to cover all of this in one lecture. So let's start. First, we'll learn how to print hello world, right? So for this, just double here, and between double code, you have to write here. Why? Because between double code, we always write string, right? So I'm going to write here, hello world, and print here. So let me make clear, and let me write python abi.py, hello world, right? Because this is between double code. If anything you want to write between double code, that means that is string, correct? But if I want to print number, so please, if you want to print number, don't write double code, just write number, correct? Okay, if you want to calculate something, maybe I want to add, okay, you can just use add, done. So this is how we print, and now we are going to print create a variable and then print the variable. Maybe I want to create a as 10, okay, and I want to print a. So 10, correct? Because a is equals to 10. What about if I want to put here double code? Now a is what? A is 10? Of course not, you see. Because a is now a, because this is between double code. So if you write anything between double code, that means that is not a variable. You see, that's not a variable, that is always a string. So you see color also change, right? So if I delete this, you see color, you see is white. Why? Because now this is variable. So run again, 10. What about if I want to add two number? So let me b equals to 20 and c equals to a plus b. So I want to print c here. So what is our answer? Answer is 30, right? 30. So we already know how to print, right? So now I'm going to ask user input from keyboard. So if you want to ask user to input, that time you have to write, maybe like I want to ask user name. So if write input, please enter your name. So if I want to user here, user going to input something here, right? And that thing in string, and I want to print what user input means user name. Understand? User going to input something here, and going to assign as a name, and the name I'm going to print the name. You see here. Asking something, let me write my name, and you see my name is Rajesh here. Bit space now. Can you see here down? Rajesh. See, my name is here, right? So this is how we write, how we ask user and input and print, right? What about number? And let me create one more here. Age or date of birth, date of birth, DB. Input, please enter your date of birth. So you are going to input date of birth, right? So date of birth always integer, but see, this is between double code, that means this is string. So this is string, so I have to change this string into integer, right? So if I want to change into integer, just make here double, here make just between bracket, and here you have to write just int. So now we are going to print, going to enter something here, means some number. That number is between double code, that means that is integer, and that integer I'm going to change into string, that integer. So I'm that integer going to assign here in db. I'm going to print db. So let me print db here. Enter. Please enter name Rajesh. Please enter date of birth 1990. Why? Because I just print db. I'm not printing name anymore. So let me print name and db together. So here my name is, this is between double quote, right? And here you have to plus and the name, correct? So this is going to print what? My name and the add string. So if this is also a string and this is also a string, right? So you can add, because this both are string, so you can add. So let me print here now. What is your name? Rajesh. Enter. You see birthday 1990. Then you see my name is Rajesh. You see my name is Rajesh. So what about, I want to print age also. So you have to write plus again and the bit space. I am, you see I am, right? So you have to write this sign here because you have this one. I am plus age, means not age, plus db, means I am, and again plus year old. Understand? So you're going to print here my name is something. You can add, because this is also a string, this is also a string, but you can add here also because this is also a string. And but you cannot add this one here or here. Why? Because this is, when you see this one is integer. So integer cannot add with string. So you have to change this integer, you have to change into string. Just change and make bracket str. That means now this one also string, correct? So let me print here. Enter. Rajesh. And the date of birth 1990. You see, my name is this one and the 1990 year old. Why? Because I enter 1990, right? So I want to find my age here now. So age equals to, now we want the 18 and the minus dash db. Enter. No. Done. So here I'm going to print now age. So let me make clear first and let me run again. Python ab. Done. No. Why? Syntax unexpected something. Unexpected what? Ah, you see here. This is unexpected. So let me clear again. Let me run again. Python and api.py. Enter name Rajesh. Date of birth 1987. You see, my name is Rajesh. I am 40 year old, right? So this is like this, but this is not the proper way to print like this. So I'm going to change everything from here and just make only one double quote. And here I'm going to write my name is name, right? I am age year old, correct? But this name is from here, so I have to put in here between these braces, and also age from here. So I'm going to print put in between braces. Now is correct. But see, the color is like this, right? So you have to change this color. That means now this is not a variable. This not that this is not equal. So if you write here F, then you see color is different, right? Now this is coming from here. This is coming from here. So this time you don't have to write here int or string. No need to change. Let me show you here. Name Rajesh 1958. You see, My name is Rajesh. I am 60 year old. Correct? So this is how we ask a user and print his name and his birthday. So what about I want to ask user name and birthday in single line. So for that, I'm just going to do this one. If you want to multiple input in single line, you just have to put comma and then you have to write DB, mean date of birth. So I'm going to change here. Please enter your name and DB, date of birth, okay? And also going to write separate with comma. So it's big. So I'm not going to, I'm going to delete these things here. That is too big, right? Input name and DB and they separate with comma. So if you want to separate with comma, here you have to write this and split, right? Split. Right, and here we have to put double comma. So correct. So I'm going to same one, nothing different. Nothing different. You see, you're going to print username and password. No, username, name, and the date of birth. That date of birth in here, that date of birth is a string, right? So I have to change that date of birth into integer here. So I'm going to this one, make between bracket and the int. Understand this one? So user going to enter his name and his date of birth, and that one separate with comma, and you see is, and this is integer, not this one now is div, right? String, right? Because it's coming from here, is string, because in between double quote. So I'm going to change here this one into integer, and the 2018 I'm going to minus this one and the age and go to print. So let me clear here. I'm going to run again Python abi.py. You see name and DB separate with comma, right? So Rajesh comma 1989. See, my name is Rajesh, I'm 29 year old. So this is very nice, and this is very nice cool effect, right? So I hope you guys understand these things, and now I'm going to change next step. So we already also learned escape sequence, right? So escape sequence is what? Just I'm going to write name, and I'm just going directly going to print, and here I'm going to write my name is Rajesh, I am 22 year old, but I'm actually not 22, I'm more than 22. So here you can print here, right? Yeah, you can, but this is not a proper, not a good way, because maybe sometime here you write single and here you write single. It both are fine, you can write single or double, not matter. But when you write single, you see here they also single, so this is going to make a problem. That sign you have to write here, so this kind of sign. So now you can see here, correct. But if you I delete this one, you're not going to run, you see, because invalid syntax. That's why I told you, anytime when you want to use this kind of letter, so you have to write here this one, correct? So D, go. So what about I'm going to write here slash n, so then slash n. No, what about if I want to use this one, this is slash, no, of course not. So let me write Celestian. What's going on? You see, this is the first line. This is first line, but this Celest, right, is going to change line, because Celestian means change the line. So it is first and change the line. So what about if you want to change, you want to print select line, that time you have to write one more select here. You see, you want to print. What about t? If you just write single means select t, that time you see between two have tab, right? So what about if you want to print t, it means select t, so you have to again double. Done. Yeah, let me delete this one. Now see what going on, just I'm writing one, nothing here. But what about if I write two here, double select, going to print one, right? Going to print one. If I want two, I have to write here four. Correct. I hope you guys understand very well these things, right? Already I teach you this everything, and today I'm just review once again. So what about operators? So let me teach you operator quickly. Very easy. 10 plus 10, so it's 20, right? Of course, yes, 20. What about 10 minus 10? 0. What about 10 multiple 10? Of course, everyone know. 100. What about if here have a, let me change quickly, 21 divide 10. So this divide is going to work for what? Is integer or float? Float. Why? Because here have 2 1, so it's going to give you answer as a point. And what about if here have 20? Also going to give you answer as a point. Of course, yes. You see 2.0. why? Because I put just single divide. If I put double, that means that's going to give you point. Even if you have here 22 or 23, it's going to give you point anymore. This is just answer 2. Even you have 29, that's going to give you point. But if you have just single, it's going to give you point. Correct. So what about modulus? Going to give you reminder. You see 9, 10, 10 and 2, 10 and 10, 20 and 9 in reminder, right? So this is all about our operators. So I hope you guys are understand everything very well, right? And it's very clear and very easy, correct? So let me teach you new, and we learn yesterday string. So in string, first thing I'm going to learn, teach you very easy slicing. So for slicing, name equals to, maybe my name is Rajesh, correct? And I want to access some name here. So print, I want to name and access only position 0, no, position 2. Position 2 means 0, 1 and 2, j, right? This is calling indexing. You see, j. What about if I, no, if I need 0? So that means position 0, right? The first one, correct? What about starting and ending? So start from 0, end 5. That means start from 0 and end 5 means at 4, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So going to print all of this, but not h. Why? Because start from 0, go until 4. Because 5 means 5 minus 1 is 4, right? You already know. So save it and go, and you see rise. If I write here 2, that means start from 2, right? So 0, 1, 2. Start from j and go until 5, means until 4. So 2 and 3 and 4, going to print j's. Just j's, you see j's. Very nice, right? So this is how we start, and how is this calling slicing. What about nothing start and nothing end? That means start from 0 and end until finish this. means print R. You see, what about if I want, okay, so now is time for step argument. So step argument always have a 3, right? 0, it's from 0 until 5, and one more here, step argument. Step argument means I want step 2. Step 2 means print 1 and the jump 1, print 1, jump 1, right? So going to print R, going to jump A, print, going to print J, going to print this, jump this one, right? So print 1, jump 1, you see, print 1 and jump 1. If I add here 3, that means print 1, jump 2, you see, R E means first print and the jump this 2 and print E, understand, right? So what about if I want to print from back side? That means time, you no need to start, no need to end, just but start minus 1 means print from back side, minus 1 means from back side, but no jump, right? So let me run here, you see, from back side. I hope you guys understand very well, right, and very clearly. And now it's time for learning our operating string method, not operating method. So for operating method is also very easy. Here I am going to like a print operating method. So let me write first here comment. So for operating method, first method, how to change uppercase. For uppercase is very easy, just write this is the name, right? So write here variable name, name, and write upper, and they don't forget bracket. So let me print here, print, and I'm going to change this one is into uppercase, right? So you have just write name dot upper bracket. Let me run here, you see all is uppercase. Even if write here more, it's also fine, everything going to upper here, you see, uppercase. And what about lowercase? Lowercase also same, just like lower. You see, lower, but it's already lower, right? So let me change this one, copy from here, I'm going to paste here. So see, also upper right and lower, but going to change everything as a lower. You see, everything is lower because I use the lower case function, right? What about I want to change as a title? Title means first letter capital and small, right? So just write title here. You see, first capital and small, capital and small. What about if you want to count the number? Means here count how many characters are here. So for count, let me write it smaller, then easy to count. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for count is very easy also. Just len and the name. Len means length. Length of name. Means very easy, 5. You see? Because here have 5 characters, right? What about you want to count only few? Maybe Rajesh. Maybe I want to count how many times have J. So for that time you have to write Raj name, just count and bracket, and inside bracket you have to write double quote, and which one you want to count. I want to count J, I want to count J. So how many times J? Just one time, right? So you're going to print 1. No, why, where is it wrong? Okay, I see len also have here. So I have to delete len. Okay, you see, one time. What about I want to count A? It's 2 times. Let me write here more. Come, come, anything. So I just want to count H here, K here. 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, right? So 4 time, you see. So it's totally what you already learned, and today I finished all about all these things. and from tomorrow, from next class, we are going to learn more, and then maybe next class is very interesting and very nice. So I hope you guys understand these videos. If you guys have any problem, please like, comment and share. And if you don't like, please also there have dislike button. So see you in next class.